Hey, what's up everybody? Jonathan here, we're back with some more Farming Simulator. Today I think what we're going to do is go ahead and cut down the rest of these trees, even though we probably won't be able to make them all in this video to the get them all to the mill, but we'll go ahead and cut them all down. That way they're there on the ground and ready to be picked up and harvested, taken to the mill. So we'll just go ahead and hop in here and get started. Alright, well, as I'm recording this video right now, it's Sunday night, the 24th, I think, yeah. They had the Indianapolis 400 NASCAR race today where Jeff Gordon filled in for the first time for Dale Earnhardt Jr. And, of course, Tony Stewart's last run in NASCAR, supposedly, so... Quite a day in NASCAR today. I'll tell you what, though, I was watching most of that race, and Kyle Busch was just, he just ran away with that thing. He set the track record, or that race record, for the most laps led, and he won the pole for yesterday's, Saturday's Xfinity race, and then won that one, and then won the pole for this one, and won it too, so he pretty much just ran away with it. Everybody else was just trying to catch him, and nobody did. A couple of guys there towards the end of the race that probably could have given him a run for the money, but on that last restart, he pretty much ran away from everybody. It was quite an ending, too. They had two green-white checker finishes, or the overtime, whatever they call it. That was pretty exciting. But anyway, that was a couple days ago. This video is probably not going to air, I think, until Tuesday morning, so a little bit of time there. But I was pretty pleased with Jeff Gordon's run. He admitted that there at the end that he didn't do very well in the restart. Of course, I wasn't really watching him too close on those, but yeah, he finished 13th, I believe, and it's a pretty solid run as far as I'm concerned with being out of the car for as long as he has, and then just having to step back in there and do, all the practice and qualifying and all that stuff. But pretty good race, I'd say. It was pretty neat at the end there to see him and Tony Stewart make a lap around the track together. That was nice. Yeah, I'll have to try to start watching some more NASCAR. I've been into it for a long time, but I kind of gotten out of it. And then where I'm living at now, I don't have cable or satellite TV. I'm just getting my channels over the air HD. But I have to try to start catching some more races. I'm a big Dale Jr. fan, so I'm looking forward to him getting back in the car. Getting healthy and racing again. I like a lot of the other drivers too. I used to not care too much for Kyle Busch, but he's just a great driver. He's winning all these races, and of course he's got a good team and good cars, but you put a terrible driver in a great car and they're not going to win, so it's a lot on the driver too. I did play around and test that Tiger Cat tracked loader I think I was talking about last video. It's going to take a little getting used to, but I think I'm going to use it. When I went ahead just a few minutes ago and modified the price in the mod description, so I set it to 500,000 just because that seemed like a a pretty realistic number, and a little bit more realistic than $10. So we'll try to build up some money and buy a few more pieces of equipment. I'll probably end up buying that one at some point and giving it a go. I don't know. I tested it some this afternoon, and it's a little clunky. I mean, it's really probably best set up if you have two joysticks, but I don't right now, so if I try it out, I'll see how it goes, and if not, then stick with my tractor with the front end loader. The one good thing about that tract loader is you can pick up multiple logs, even some multiple big ones. But I think what we're gonna do, maybe after we make a couple of runs to the mill, probably looking to buy a chipper and a trailer and maybe another truck before I get the loader. I'd like to get a little chipping operation set up after we've, you know, left this site. We're leaving behind a lot of these smaller tops that we can use for wood chips, and then maybe some of these fields that we've been planting, we can, you know, use one or two of those fields as a chipping operation. Maybe harvest the trees when they're not fully grown or something like that, just to get a little more income going. And then we'll have to set up course play to at least get some of the log trucks and whatnot going to some of these places, so we don't have to worry about driving them there ourselves and back. And probably also buying another log trailer and setting up course plays, so while the first truck's gone to the mill, we can start loading up another trailer. And that should speed things up a little. Too bad you can't hire a driver to take the truck to the mill. That'd be pretty cool. Maybe in some of the future versions of the game to come out with something like that, where you can hire a driver. In fact, what we'll do here in just a little bit is I will go ahead and get course play set up for the truck to go to the mill from here. Go ahead and get that started. That's a pretty simple operation there. I wonder what was going on with the NASCAR race. Of course, I haven't seen too many of them this season, but it looked like there wasn't many people in the stands. I don't know. The camera just didn't, catch the right spots or what. But gosh, some of the the front stretch, the main stretch there, were all in front of the pits and everything. Nobody was in. There was some, but not many people in the stands at all, from what I could tell. knew NASCAR's been having some, you know, attendance issues with the, well, especially in the last few years with the way the economy's been, just not much, you know, money to go around. But, you know, just from experience, I know some of those tickets, I mean, especially the lower ones, aren't really that expensive. Unless they've really upped them since I went. The city as big as Indianapolis, you would think that some of the local folks would at least attend, which that may have been all that was there, I don't know. Good thing I'm not a harvester operator. I would have been fired already. Just about tipped it over there. For those of you that are really into the forestry on this game, if you haven't already, you need to check out the Rockwood map. That's a pretty cool map. The only thing I don't like about it is they don't have, you know, the ability to plant trees. You can just really just cut them down. And there's no fields to buy to plant trees, which I'm pretty sure that you can't plant trees. I haven't really looked into it that close. I have played it quite a bit, but I just don't remember if there's a tree plant. I don't think there is. But anyway, it's a pretty cool map, though. It's really got a lot of terrain to it, a lot of neat little logging roads, just a ton of trees, too. But I wanted to be able to buy some fields and plant some trees, which is why I'm playing this map in the world. I just about tipped it over. Well, before we get too much further here into the cutting, let's hop out and set that course play up. Let's see. Got a good bit of logs over here on this side, and just a few more trees to cut down there. So I think what I'm going to do is just pull the truck up a little bit and stop it right about there. Okay, so now you right click, which brings up the course play control, and you click on start course recording, and then you just take off. Make sure that we don't go too fast around this curve when we throw our logs everywhere. Sure that we don't go too fast in general, just so we don't mess up here. And what I think I'm going to do is stop it right about here. And we'll set a waypoint. And then we'll go ahead and stop it. Okay. So then we're going to want to save that. And I'm going to call this to the mill. There we go. So now, you know, we can stop it there, and when we get our logs, we can, you know, back in whatever, and then when we get ready to head back to our job site, let's see, we'll be kind of coming out right about there. So I'm gonna go ahead and set it right about here. So we'll drive to here. And then we'll need a new course back. So we'll set that one there. And since we'll be empty, we can just kind of forward up this hill now and around. Try to stick to the roads, we'll keep it at least somewhat legit. And then we will turn it around. And we'll come back to where we started. And set a waypoint and stop. Okay. Then we'll save this one as return from mill. Alright. Let me close that and get back to our log in here. Let's see, I think I'm going to go ahead and load up a few just so we've got time in this video to show you what that course play will do for you. Okay, so I'm going to drop this stump cutter thing off over here. I'm going to go get our weight where I left it. Whoops. Well, here we go again. Stuck. It was on the right side. Oh well. I think I needed to flip it around, but it was right to begin with. I wish that grapple was just a little bit bigger. Maybe we'll be able to get both of these this time. Take it kind of slow. playing a big game of pickup sticks. Yeah, I'm pretty anxious to see what all is going to be new in Farming Simulator 2017. I watched a little video today, which was, I guess it was really the first little teaser video they put out. I think they had a Caterpillar Challenger tractor in there, so I'm wondering if they, with the forestry, you know, if they wouldn't put out maybe a Caterpillar skidder or something, or some kind of other forestry equipment that comes with the game. That'd be pretty neat. Keeps getting stuck in the grapple. There it goes, finally. The course play is really going to come in handy whenever we've got some fields at the bottom of the map that we're harvesting and needing to transport the wood all the way up to the mill. That's going to come in real handy to be able to just set the truck off by itself and continue loading up another trailer or something while it's going there and back. See here in a minute how this course play does with this particular setup. we got room for maybe two or three more. And we'll send it off. Sure is gonna be a pain going back and picking up all them little tops. I may have to, either with this tractor or something else we can purchase, may have to kind of try to push them into a pile or something where we can load them up easier. I don't know. See what I can think of. Alright, get out of there. Couple more. Let's see if we can get these two right here. This is gonna work. Oh well. Might as well not waste too much time trying to get both of those. Maybe if this one was a little smaller, it might have worked. It's a pretty good sized tree there. That should be good enough for that load. So let's get the tractor out of the way. And we'll hop in the truck and send it off. Okay, so to use the course plate, we just right click and we'll have to go to, let's see, I believe it's, we gotta load the course, so we'll put to the mill and click the little folder button, and then go back to this button here, the course plate control, and just tell it drive course, and off it goes. Now I'm not on the gas or anything. In fact, I'll just hop out. Yep, see, there it goes. And what we can do is hop in this tractor down here and watch it go by. Yep, so there it went. In fact, we'll we'll tail it. Make sure it doesn't have any hiccups. See, it took that corner pretty slow, just like we did it in the setup. And of course, down the hill it speeds up a little. It should come to a stop here any second. Yep, there we go, and it says at the left over there the truck has reached the waiting point. And then from here we'll just hop out, get back in the truck. We have to stop it, so right click on the mouse and tell it stop driver, and close that, and then we'll back it on into the pond and then start the next course back. So we'll pull up here to where we have the next course, the return course. Oops, didn't go too far. Okay, so we right click again, and this time I want to go back and load in the return to the mill course there, and go back to course play control, and drive course, and off it goes. Oh, well, it's, I think it's trying to get turned around. Must not have had it exactly. Yeah, it's trying to get turned around, and it's gonna hit that stump. Great. Alright, well, we'll just stop it and try it again. I'll have to remember in the future to pull back a little bit. Even a little bit further. Try it right here. And then continue. Alright, now we're going. So that's pretty cool. I mean, I could have been back at the logging site, you know, loading up another trailer or something. That'll come in handy. Well, that thing was really moving. Goes. And if it does it correctly, it should spin around and stop back where we stopped it on the course play setup. Yep, that's pretty cool. Yeah, the course play comes in really handy a lot of times. I've set it up before to cut grass and rake grass and pick it up even, as, and then take it to the biogas plant, so that's pretty neat. Okay, well, let's pretty quickly, let's load up another trailer full here, and we'll make another run, and then we'll purchase some equipment before we cut the video off this time. I believe I mentioned before we ended the last video that I was going to purchase another field and get it planted off camera so we wouldn't have to watch. You know, that monotonous nonsense. But anyway, I did purchase field number one, which is, if you look from where we're at here, just to the left over there past the truck, over the top of the truck, is about where that field is. I did get it planted, and it's, you know, growing, so it'll take a while, but eventually we'll have us another field of trees. Okay, let me stop this driver real quick just so we don't have this, have to hop in the truck. And we'll stop the driver. Alright. I did not get centered on that one. Tractor's struggling on this one. Oh, there it goes. About to say, that big old log, surely it can't get stuck in there. And I was trying to pull it on the side of the trailer so it would come out. Yeah, after this next run of the mill, we should have, I would think, probably about 300,000. Maybe that'll be enough to buy us a chip trailer. Well, we'll need another truck too, probably. Maybe we'll get a chipper and a trailer at least. We can start, you know, chipping up some wood and putting in a trailer. I can probably just use this truck to alternate. I can drop the trailer off and use the truck to, when the chipper's full, to grab it and take it to where it needs to be sold. I'll probably set up a course play route for that, because it is, I think, a little bit of ways from here. Maybe when we get enough, we can, after that, we can buy a new truck. I've got a nice Peterbilt mod. You can pick a bunch of different colors for your truck, and the mod itself is really nice. I'll probably end up going with those. Either the Peterbilts or the Kenworths. I also got a nice Kenworth mod. I don't know. I'm pretty partial to Peterbilts, but I have to look at that. Well, I think actually the prices are roughly the same, so I'll probably will just end up going to Peterbilt. The Kenworths do have nice sound effects, so whenever you shut the truck off, it, you know, kind of powers down or whatever you want to call it. Pretty neat sound to it. But the Peterbilt's a really stable mod. I like it. It runs really good, pulls good, and then whenever you pull up to a corner and kind of let off the gas, it'll kind of slow you down, which is a nice effect. You have to hit the brakes. Sent that one flying. Kind of got squirrely on me there. There we go. We'll deal with that one later. Maybe it'll fall into place whenever we start putting a few more logs in there. Before long here on our game map, it's going to be getting dark. I think we're at, what, about 5:30 right now. So I will most likely be working some into the night just so you can see the lights. I think that's a pretty neat effect. But when it gets good and fully dark, I'm going to go ahead and skip forward in time to get to back to the early morning so we can see everything good. I would say there's probably some logging operations that have a night shift and a bunch of lights and stuff, but in general, forestry is pretty dangerous, you know, dropping trees and all the heavy equipment and stuff, so I certainly wouldn't want to be working at night. Let's see what we can do about this problem log here. Might be able to just grab it with the fork or I can push it. Nope, can't get close enough. Well, maybe I can just kind of lift up on it and gonna have to grab it and reposition it. Get it down here on the heavy end so I'm not worried about tipping over or anything. Probably going to try to anyway. Yeah. Pretty good. Maybe three more logs, four more, I don't know, and then that'll be it for this load. Be nice if I could grab these two right here. We'll say maybe two more, then we'll send it off. And then I'm going to go up there and show you the field we bought and planted. Oh yeah, that'll work. Okay. Let's send this guy off. And while he's gone, let's see. Let me grab this other tractor over here. Let's check out this field real quick. Alright, well here it is. We bought this one and I've got it planted. I don't know if you can see the seedlings there. But it's all planted up and growing and pretty close to the mill, so whenever we get ready to harvest these, we won't have very far to go, and should be some quick turnaround money there. It's not a big field, but a bunch of trees in there. Okay. So our truck has reached the mill. And we'll stop the driver. This time to not pull up so far. Maybe that'll work. So let's do return from the mill. Comes. Okay, so let's go ahead and see what we can purchase. We got quite a bit built up now, so let's see. I know for a fact I've got a trailer in the mods that we can use for the chips. See if it's in this forestry section. Don't see it. Oh, you can see here the Tiger Cat loader. We did go ahead and switch that up to 500,000 just to make it a little bit more realistic. Maybe it's under tippers. Let's look. Yep, there it is. All right, this dump trailer. That's pretty cool. We'll go ahead and buy that. And we're going to need a chipper. So let's see what we got for forestry equipment. Now this Crasher one here, I've used that before. That works out pretty good. The one we'll really need is this Beast. That thing is pretty awesome. Also got a nice price tag. Making sure there's nothing else. This one here, this Jen's back, whatever, that's okay. I don't like the ones that's got the conveyor belt. So let's go back here to this other one. Let's go ahead and buy it. All right, and that should get us in business with some wood chips. Grab my truck here. And looks like we need to go this way. I going the right way. Nope. Going the other way. As much as I played this map, you would think I'd know where the shop is by now. Apparently not. We'll use this truck to take our wood chipper over there to where we're logging at now and just go ahead and drop it off, and then we'll grab the big truck once it gets back to the stopping point, which it probably should have by now. But anyway, we'll have to use it, of course, to get the bigger trailer. And I hope that... Alright, there's a truck. Alright, I hope that I hope that this chipper can... the boom or whatever can... Whoa, looks like we had a collision here. Oh, that's interesting. Maybe I can just push it. No, I don't recall it doing that. Maybe they'll let us hook it up still, though. Well... Let me grab this tractor real quick. I'll take a minute to drive it over there, but... Sometimes with these maps, I wish it was a little bit easier to edit things, like, you know, getting rid of some of these buildings we don't need. I mean, if we're just doing forestry, we don't need the biogas or whatever that stuff is, you know, some of these other buildings, but maybe they'll include some sort of a forestry type map in the 17. Okay, so let's see. Do it right there. Okay. And let's get that tractor out of the way. Yes, it's a pretty good sized chipper. The only thing I'm worried about, well, let's see, we can actually test it right here. We'll do the pipe out. And, yeah, looks like it's gonna clear it. Maybe, yeah. Yeah, I guess, yeah, that'll work. Alright, we're in business. Get that hauled over there. Pretty good sized wood chipper. You know, just drop the wood in there and it'll chip it up. The loader thing on there is pretty much worthless. I've been frustrated a lot with that thing. So we will not be using that. see, we're going to have to back our trailer in here probably, so I think I'm going to set it up maybe just to, let's see, the pipe's on the left side, so I'll put it, well, if the truck will cooperate, I'll put it right about here. Actually, you know, there's, yeah, this part of the map is where I was using the tree length log, so there is no tops over here. We'll have to move it back over this way. Forgot about that. Just wondering why there wasn't any treetops over there. Yeah, this will work. We'll put it right over here in the shade. That'll be perfect, because then we can come down the hill if we need to. Well, actually, I think I'll move it up just a little. Give our tractor a little bit of room to maneuver. And we'll give that a shot. Okay, so let's stop this guy. And we'll unhook. And let's go get our wood chip trailer. This thing's pretty neat because you can put the cover. Oops. Well. Well, I thought you could put the cover on, but apparently X. Let's see, let me try on the keyboard. And there it goes. Yeah, so X on my gamepad is not going to work because it just hops me out of the truck. But X on the keyboard works. Pretty long trailer. I mean, this thing will hold a lot of wood chips too. 1,342 liters, whatever that is. I don't know. Up on cubic feet, yards, whatever. I don't know. Not up on all this metric stuff. Come around this way because the wood chip place, I believe, is back to our left there. Let's see, where is it? I think it's at the windmill, maybe. Oh well, figure it out later. Get my trailer parked in place. See if that's gonna work. Oops, wrong one. Yeah, that's gonna work. All right. So next time we'll get a few chips started and set up a course play to get the wood chips to the spot where you sell them. And probably do another load or two to the mill. And probably from there, maybe we can buy us a truck, another truck. Okay. Okay. Well, I think that's going to do it for this time. And next time we'll do some wood chipping. And until then, have a good one. See you later.